So from left hand side, we start 0 to a f of x dx. Here we can experience that x should be replaced by a minus x, but directly we cannot write like x is equal to a plus a minus x. So we use another variable t for this, and we replace x by a minus t, means we substitute x is equal to a minus t. Dx by dt will be minus 1. This implies dx is equal to minus dt. Now let's change the limits as per our substitution. So when x is 0, 0 is equal to a minus t implies t is equal to a, and when x is equal to a is equal to a minus t implies t is equal to 0. So the left hand side becomes zero. Instead of 0 to a, limits will be now a to 0. F of a minus t and dx is minus dt. Now on interchanging limits 0 to a negative sign will come out. So it becomes f of a minus t minus 0 to a f of a minus t minus dt minus, and this minus will cancel each other. We have used a property a to b phi of x dx is same as minus b to a phi of x dx. Now, as we know that definite integrals are independent of variables, so we can write 0 to a f of a minus x dx, because we know that definite integrals are independent of variables. So a to b phi of x dx, a to b phi of t dt, both are same. And again I am saying that about this substitution x is equal to a minus t, once we change the limits after substitution and as per the substitution, we do not care about substitution now after changing limits. So once we change the limit, importance of substitution gets over. So here we have replaced t by x using this property. We are not caring of the substitution which we have substituted x is equal to a minus t. So in indefinite integrals, we replace the value of t with the help of this substitution, but in definite, once we change the limits, we do not care of substitutions. What substitution we have used, we forget that. So here, and in this situation, we have replaced t by x using this property, which says that definite integrals are independent by x or by y or by z or by any other variable. But why we have chosen t is equal to x? because to prove this property, if you think that if t is replaced by y, then the property will not be proved. So it is just an illusion. Property is already proved, whether it is t or it is y or it is x or it is z, because definite integrals are independent of variables. So whether you write it zero to right hand side, 0 to a f of a minus x dx, or 0 to a f of a minus t dt, or f of a minus y dy, no matter, all are same. Okay, so this was all about this property. I hope the property is clear.